I do not care if you have cancer. My child deserves your seat. A little backstory. About a year ago, I was diagnosed with cancer of the nasal cavity, stage 2. The tumor was quite large, thankfully benign. And benign might not be the right word since I'm translating this to English, but more specifically, it was contained, meaning it didn't spread into other tissue. I apologize for gaps in my knowledge. To get it removed, I first had to undergo aggressive chemotherapy to make it smaller. Thanks to chemo, I had severe alopecia, which is hair loss, which made me and most of my hair, even my eyebrows and eyelashes, fall out. At some point, I had to go bald, but I wore a wig because I didn't want to look like a skinhead or neo-Nazi. I thought people would assume this. So once, after a long chemo session in the hospital, I took the bus home. There's only one bus that goes from the hospital to where I live, so I took that one only to see it was absolutely packed. I felt terrible thanks to the chemo. So I asked a middle-aged dude to let me sit. He was very understanding and gave me his spot without complaining. Two stops later, the entitled mother, a lovely whale with an I demand parley with the CEO haircut and a 12-year-old kid enter. It took her roughly 5 seconds to see that the bus was packed, start looking for a free seat, spot me, and start marching, or in her case, trying to fit in the aisle between the seats while shoving others aside to me. When I saw her, I knew it was going to be bad. She then stood next to me and decided to talk to me. This was the conversation that followed. Entitled mother:
hey, could you let my kid sit down?
Me: you mean me? Entitled mother:
who else?
Me: oh, I'm sorry, but I'm on the way back from the hospital. And entitled mother:
so are we.
Which is nonsense because the stop was a few kilometers away from the hospital.
My boy just broke his leg and we're coming straight from the ER.
Her kid was standing next to her without any support, clearly embarrassed. Me: he's standing next to you completely fine.
Look here, boy.
Also, I'm 21 years old.
My kid deserves to sit down.
Look, madam, I'm sorry, but I just got back from a chemo session in the hospital. I need to sit and rest. I then move my wig back a bit to show her my bald head. Entitled mother then starts yelling in my face,
stop making excuses and get off the seat, you skinhead.
At this point, I was baffled. I didn't even know what to say. The kid was trying to make his mother stop and we had the attention of the whole bus. She then grabbed me and tried to yank me from my seat. I held on tight and thankfully I didn't fall off. Now, enter OG, my savior, which is the older gentleman.
Will you shut up, cow?
Entitled mother says,
who do you think you're talking to?
OG, with an ice cold voice, said, stop assaulting other passengers or I will be forced to step in. Also, every dumb moron could see the dude has cancer.
No, he's just a skinhead.
He's got no eyebrows. It seems like that really offended entitled mother because she spun around on the spot and threw a falcon punch in the older gentleman's face. I was in shock and in disbelief. The whole bus was flabbergasted and the kid probably wished he'd never been born. The older gentleman said something unbelievable and a golden sweet karma moment followed. Okay, that does it. Harassing passengers on a bus, physically assault against a passenger, and now assaulting an officer? You're in deep trouble, lady. The older gentleman then pulled out a badge and told her to stay where she was. He then pulled out his phone, called someone, and told her that she was being arrested. I could not believe it. The older gentleman was a cop. At this point, the entitled mother was white as a wall. The bus had come to a stop, so she decided to make a run for it, but other passengers blocked her way. She also then got charged with resisting arrest thanks to this. Three stops later, a police car was waiting for the entitled mother and the entitled kid, or embarrassed kid. The embarrassed kid told me he was sorry for his mother's behavior, and I felt really sorry for the kid. He wasn't a bad kid, but his mother was a hellspawn. The older gentleman talked to me and asked me if I wanted to press charges, to which I gladly said yes. Took a statement and thankfully was kind enough to let me solve everything on the phone so I didn't have to come into the police station for questioning. In the end, entitled mother got some jail time and community service. I, in return, got a good story to tell and the sweet taste of instant karma. Right now, I'm riding the same bus home and I just got back home from the hospital after the checkup, which reminded me of this. A friend who sitting next to me told me I should post it. He, as much as myself, couldn't believe such people existed, but it seems I proved it to him. I should also note that the surgery went well and I was declared cancer-free in November and my hair is slowly returning. Also, I don't need to wear a wig anymore. The best part of this story is that he ended up being cancer-free. That's what I was hoping to hear the entire time, but right at the very end, he threw it in there. So I'm assuming this didn't happen in the United States since he said he had to translate this from another language, but I mean, maybe it could have been in Spanish and he was translating to English. I'm not really sure, but I'm guessing it probably wasn't in the US. But that said, this is still assaulting an officer, which I assume in most countries is probably a pretty huge deal, and it makes sense why she would potentially end up going to jail. I do feel bad for that kid because he's trying to get her to chill out and she ended up punching a cop, throwing her in jail, and who knows what happened to the kid. Hopefully there was some other family to take care of this kid. I've actually seen a lot of these freak out videos where the kid is trying to keep the parent from going crazy and the parents end up going crazy and getting arrested. And this seems like one of those sad scenarios, but let me know what you guys think down below. Who was the jerk here and what would you do if you were in this situation? I'm a 23-year-old female and my family is pressuring me to give my 28-year-old sister my wedding venue because she needs it more and is pregnant. My fiance and I have been together for 8 years and engaged for 3. I was doing my PhD program and was juggling planning the wedding. My fiance took much of that work, but it was perfect because our dream venue was booked until after my graduation. So what we did was book our dream venue 3 years in advance. It really is a beautiful venue. The only slot that we got was September of this year. My sister got engaged a few months ago to her fiance. They were planning on having a spring wedding next year. They had no venue lined up, but had a few vendors lined up as well as a set date. Yesterday, our parents invited us and our significant others to a family barbecue where my sister announced to our extended family that she is expecting a baby. Everyone was so happy for her and my brother-in-law, who is a great guy. My nan asked my sister if the wedding was still on the set date or if they were going to wait because of the baby. She said no, that she hoped to move it to September. No big deal. We don't have many out-of-town guests, so they could attend both weddings, no problem. Nan was happy and asked my sister if she needed help planning such a short notice wedding. My sister turned around and said, "That's what I wanted to talk to you about. I was really hoping we could kind of like take your venue. I really cannot stress myself too much with planning a wedding while going to maternity classes, and I think it is so beautiful. It would really mean a lot to me." It went silent, but everyone was looking at me, expecting me to say, "Yes, of course, everything for my little sister." My brother-in-law looked very uncomfortable and told her that they had just talked about this and that it was not okay to put me on the spot. But my sister just said, "Oh, don't be like that. My sister wants to do what's best for me, so it's no big deal, right?" I just said, "Well, kind of is. I don't know. I have my heart really set on the venue." Cue the crying. She stormed off. Nan told me I was being selfish because she needed the venue more than I did. I tried to defend myself, and my mother said, "You waited 3 years. Would it have killed you to wait a few more months? When has your sister ever asked you for something?" A few comments later, my fiance got really mad and we left. My sister called me crying and said that it was unfair. I always get what I want and that I could have just done this one thing for her. Dad said it's just a venue and what matters is the person who you are marrying. He is kind of right, but we have been planning for so long. My fiance is furious with my family and doesn't even want my sister to come. Now, my family is threatening not to come because I am being selfish and my sister needs it more than me because having a baby is too stressful. My brother-in-law called me and apologized for the inconvenience. He told me he had discussed it with my sister and she had told him she would not ask. He is properly mad with her now and warned me that my sister is blaming me for, quote, potentially ruining her marriage. My father has sent me about 5 texts along the lines of, "I hope you are happy. Your sister hasn't stopped crying since yesterday," and so on and so on. My fiance and I have decided to boot my sister from the bridal party and replace her with my aunt, who is the only family member that took my side. We have not decided whether or not we will invite my family as a whole. Furthermore, my mom took it upon herself to tell on us. She called the fiance's parents and told them that it would be best if my sister gets it because she is pregnant and pre-eclampsia runs in my family, whatever that means. I actually had to look up what that was, and apparently it's a rare but serious condition where high blood pressure results in seizures during pregnancy. My future father-in-law told them to piss off and basically rip my mom a new one for expecting something so ridiculous and that they were going to lose me if they kept playing favorites. So my mom is now crying too and saying that my father-in-law is a jerk. This is just getting so pathetic. It seems straight out of a bad soap opera. My in-laws are driving to us currently with some supper and wine and basically told me not to worry and that no matter what happens, they will be my safety net. I cried out of happiness. So it hasn't been that long, but when I first posted about this, it blew up. I was expecting only a few answers, but the support was overwhelming. What boggled my mind was that this story was flooded over to mainstream media. But let's get to the story. So, since this all went viral, a lot happened. My sister saw this story while browsing on Reddit, and she lost her mind. She accused me of painting her like a loony and misinterpreting facts. Side info, my sister got wind of the situation due to various media outlets and then went on Reddit. She said that I was being unfair. She says that she is family and that she asked for it nicely because she loves me. She also underlines the fact that the opinion of internet strangers doesn't count because family is more important and I should focus on making my family happy. The only text I sent back was this: "I'm sorry that you perceived it that way. I did not in any manner distort what happened. As you might notice, I didn't describe your tone nor exaggerated anything. Perhaps you have that night different in your mind than I do, but I digress. I'm sick and tired of bending to your will. My whole life I have been your servant and your doormat. Remember all the birthdays I had to share with you because you would throw a tantrum because you didn't get presents? Or when you cried so that I would fill out job applications for you? But the thing that has hurt me the most, till now, is when you ruined my graduation. I am done. I admit that I also spoiled you, but I will not any longer. If you want to marry so bad before your baby is born, then you could look at the blank hotel that offers last minute weddings. I have spent too much time planning my wedding to gift it to you. And if you want to ruin our relationship over this, then go ahead. I will sleep sound and safe knowing that it wasn't my fault." She only responded by saying, "Wow, you must love me so very much." And then she blocked me. But this morning, she unblocked me to send me this. "Wedding planner. Hello dear, I got the message from your mother and will proceed with the rebooking of the venue on the spot. However, this will have extra costs as we have to change the names on the contract. Please come by the office tomorrow so we can sign the new contract." Sister responds saying, "That's great, I'll be there at 9. My parents haven't actually written me since the thing with my father-in-law. My older brother, yes I have an older brother but he lives in another city and he wasn't at the barbecue, that's why I didn't mention him. Plus, he initially could not come to the wedding because of work and changed his plans after hearing all about the story, contacted me and wanted to know what happened because we got a weird story from mom and dad. Mom had told him I had offered previous to the barbecue to give up the venue to my sister and that I humiliated her. I told him what really happened and he had no problem believing me. We talked about our parents' behavior and he confessed that him moving was partly due to our parents being, and I quote, jerkheads to us. He told me that my mom had gotten wind from the post and was mad at me for betraying my family. I haven't written my parents what so many of you advised me to because I have come to terms with the fact that they love my sister more than me, if they love me at all. So for the wedding, we sat together and put passwords with the majority of our vendors and also with the venue directly. We didn't talk to our planner yet, which is why the text of my sister worries me so much. Also, we canceled the catering that my parents paid for. So short term, we won't be able to get full catering like we wanted to, but all of our friends, my fiance's family, will help us prepare a buffet and everyone's gonna chip in. That will be our bachelor party. As we will have to spend more on our food now, we canceled our bachelor parties and will have a family and friends cooking session. Thank you everyone for helping me see how toxic my family is. I will try to sort it out. If they do apologize from the bottom of their hearts, they will be allowed into my wedding. But if not, then, well, I will still have my brother who will be walking me down the aisle and my aunt. So the conclusion to everything is we called my planner and she was horrified. She told me she had never as much talked to my mother since the day we went to book the venue. She assured me that even if they were to call and say that I wanted it, I had to be present to make any changes. So we informed everyone that will work for us on our wedding and they offered to hire security for that day at a reduced price. Am I the jerk? This post seems like it really got under a lot of people's skin. One of the top opinions on this was speaking to the OP sister directly saying that you claim the OP isn't doing this for you despite being family. Ask yourself, have you been doing your part as her family? She's been planning this for 3 years and you want to just take it away from her. Should family be doing this? And this is absolutely true. It seems like from the way the OP tells it, the sister is in a very one-sided relationship with not only her sister, but the rest of the family. She's almost exclusively taking and not giving. And in a way, kind of betrayed her own fiance because it sounded like they had an agreement that she wasn't going to bring this up and put her sister on the spot, but yet somehow decided in the moment to do it, not only to make her sister feel uncomfortable, which is the OP, but also her own fiance. There's a few people that were diagnosing the sister in the situation because they were saying that she is kind of a jerk, but probably knows it and doesn't care. But somebody actually responded by saying, not necessarily. If she has narcissistic tendencies, she might legitimately just straight up not give a second thought to how her actions might affect others. That means she does not apply the same critical thinking to her actions that she applies to others' actions affecting her. The step is just omitted in the thought sequence in the brain. Sadly, I know this from experience. I mean, if this was the case, then the entire family enabling this behavior probably only makes it more normalized in her mind. But this whole situation is a pretty big one. It sounds like the OP is going to go down fighting and not give up her venue. But what would you do in this situation? And who do you think was the jerk? Don't forget to drop a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. If you want to submit your own stories to be shared here on the channel, check out the link in the description.